Blub blub everyone, welcome back to the Terran Star Empire in Stellaris. As you can see, I play with a few mods. This one is actually one I remade or I fixed for this latest patch. Didn't start yet, just loaded in. And our origin, well, we read our origin in the part zero. If you didn't hear that, or if you didn't see it, just watch the part and you will be in the picture right here. And now let's see how our ruler intends to bring us into this new universe, which is actually a known universe, but just different, you know? Just different. It's kind of known. We weren't far apart. Actually, I don't think the BattleTech universe has spiral arms, but we don't care about that right here. It's fine. Doesn't have to be perfect. I just wanted to set the theme, and we can already see two worlds for us. This one is pretty bad, but the 20 tropical, I'm gonna take that. That's nice. So we are pretty close to the galactic core, which is interesting. Okay. Well then. Let's do this. Now, first, what do we want to research? Actually, the 5% research speed across the board is nice. And is probably better than the physics research from researchers. Although, I would have always taken this otherwise. This will be 10% is about 0.9, so 20% is 1.8 or something. Yeah, this could be better because it's after all the bonuses in here. I think we'll take that. Then, more food though. Food is nice. Nah, we'll take the research, which will be better here. Mining station and nebula refinery. Is there a nebula close? Well, down here there is a nebula. But yeah, I don't think so. Let's just go for research first. That is always a powerful move. And let's hope for the best, right? Let's hope for the best. Anything else we have to think about? Yes, we have to use our researcher right here. And survey a little. Interesting thing is we need more of them. I will do a little, let's say, trick. It's not really a trick. Ship designer. I have about, by the way, I have about 500 hours in this game, so I know my way around a little. You might say, yes, I want that. That's fine. Oh, yeah. No, I don't. That is the little trick. Which is actually something people do. Playing multiplayer and competitively. Actually, I just want to save this design without the stupid auto thing. Let's just stay there and, yeah, replace those. Let's make it 3 and 3. We won't use these stations anyway yet, but that's fine. We want to do this because our fleet can now be upgraded and we get more alloys, which is very nice. We want to play a little faster too, and yeah, I want to get rid of this and that. No, that was the wrong one. This one and that one. Okay, because this shall be number one. No, actually, the station shall be number one. No, it's fine. It's fine. We shall stay like this. And still need the station though, because we want another science ship ASAP.
Vessels upgraded.
Perfect. I hope the music and this stuff is in good shape and loud enough. We have a princess, which is interesting. Hello there, Martina Salazar. Great. Not very skilled, charismatic investigator. Oh, investor. Investigator? Don't know where that came from. Edict cost minus 10%. Edict duration plus 20%. That's actually pretty nice. And a trade value plus 10%, which we already have, so that will stay. This is extremely, extremely cool. 25% less cost on every station in our home system is amazing. Thing is that a good system? That's kind of okay. It's some energy, some minerals. The research is not that important at the moment to me. Although it will be very soon. We have another science ship. Do we have enough money? Yes, we do. Can we get someone... Oh, I want both. I actually want you, because we will need you. But I want you to ASAP. Okay. Just gain some experience for us. Okay. We will want more of them. So let's just get another one. Get another one going. Okay. I'm very, very curious which races made it into the game. I literally took 7 to 15 into this game. And I don't know. I don't know which are in. I forced them in, all my races I made. But I don't know which are in. I hope interesting ones. I hope they are all interesting in a way, but we will see about that. Oh my god. We already have a maniacal one for society research. We could get two great people now. I want the maniacal one, and there's a good and valid reason for me to do so. That's fine. Because maniacal researchers can discover that their bonus is less. It's 5% less than the genius ones. And we want the genius in here. But the maniacal researchers can find rare technologies and even the dangerous technologies quicker. Which is great, and we want that. I'm actually thinking about putting the genius in here and the maniacal up in here, because I really don't care that much about society, maybe. It depends. It really depends. I'm aiming for 30-minute episodes, by the way, so we'll try to do that. Okay, you are already in. Where would you go? The problem is the lanes are strange. But I think you should go here. Yeah, and you will go here and here, and we will see how the lanes part open. I want another one to go here and probably go down south. You in the east, you are in the north, and you in the west, and then branching out somewhere. So we probably want a fourth one. Can we afford one? Almost. Of course we will refurbish our fleets. I know it's not really in the setting that we would just leave our fleet without weapons, but well, times are harsh, you know? Completed the construction of a mining station. Good. Good, good, good. So this is done now. We can get the research station. I think we will. And then we will move on to our new planet. Soon to be new planet. And the thing is, even these stations are, I think, reduced in cost, right? No, it's just mining stations. Okay, that's fine then. It's okay. Doesn't really matter. What do we have on Terra? Commercial zone, research lab. Okay, the standard. I want something else. Can I afford this? Not yet. I need 400. I actually want the Holo Theater. Normally I would buy, build, not buy, not buying. The Autotone Monument, because I want the unity. But for us, because we are a warrior culture, we generate unity through holo theaters, so we can spam them and increase amenities to unbelievably much. The only problem is we need alloys for this, and for this we would need consumer goods. Still, I still think it's better, because we need less alloys than we need consumer goods. And we gain the same amount of unity. I don't care that much about the society research, so that is actually what I want to do. Let's do that. Tell me, did anyone of you already play Stellaris? And if no, you probably should. if you didn't. I really enjoy this game. And I think having my own races in here that I thought up, hopefully in the best way imaginable, no, leave this, and build together with a theme behind it will make it very interesting, I hope. Although the names, of course, won't be recognizable because it's not in the setting. Actually, this species is the only thing from the setting that survived. Volatile modes is actually pretty good. Interesting. I want another science ship. And that should be about it, I guess. Wait, let's get another leader. Leaders. I want the... Yeah, I want you. And I want you to replace probably you. Probably you, let's see. Yeah. And I'm still debating putting you there. I'm thinking about what good science comes from, or good technologies come from physics. There are a few, like jump drives and such, so... From society, I'm not sure, some cloning stuff and such. Oh, we'll see. I think we replace you with this person, this woman. And put you out of a job for a moment until the science ship is finished. We can't do that. Just fine. Just ignore it for the moment. As you can see, we are using, or I am using, some mods, the Tiny Outliner with tiny fleets and stuff, all together. Amazing mods. I love these. I do love these. And I'm probably gonna prepare a mod list. If I didn't link it somehow, just Google Documents or something. If I didn't, no. Better idea. I already have a Iron Man single player mod collection on Steam, so I probably link that one. And if I forget, please remind me in the comments, because that could happen. And you know, I want to make good on my word. Okay, there we are. We have the potential to colonize now. We don't have the material, but we have the potential, so we should use that as soon as possible. And oh my god, I love these industrial districts, and I want a lot of them. It's pretty nice. I loved that change. I think we will go for expansion. We have to rediscover the universe, not only scientifically, but more so in expansionist terms, because we were trapped on this planet for a long while. So I think expansion is the best direction. After we discovered what's around us, we probably want to discover it scientifically and search for the big enemy that destroyed us before. And hopefully find some evidence of what happened, maybe find out who it was and how we can prepare. We will see. For that, we also have the remnants of our former society still on our planet, which is... No, it's these. Pretty cheap to get. No, well, this is not that cheap, but still. This will give us a lot of interesting stuff. And I hope it'll be worth it to find lost technologies and everything. Not to reinvent the wheel, you know? Just find out what happened, give us a boost, so we are a little ahead, and maybe be prepared this time. So, the Eressian Concordat, I'm gonna read this real quick. We have recovered artifacts from an ancient alien civilization on Pegol 5. From what we have translated so far of their language, we have learned that these aliens called themselves the Eressian Concordat. They were an interstellar power that held sway over this region of the galaxy a little over a million years ago. So probably even before we did. Well, not only probably, for sure, but we haven't found anything before. This is interesting. They appear to have been 6 limbed mammalians, and there are several references to some sort of plague called the Javorian Pox, which swept across their empire with devastating results, possibly leading to their extinction. This is one of the many precursors you can have. I was hoping for another, just to be clear on that. But it's fine. Every precursor, if we can finish the chain, is good and interesting. We've discovered an abandoned solar sail ship in orbit around Propos 5. The sublight vessel was built by an unknown culture and appears to be several thousand years old. One of the massive sails has a large tear where some kind of object passed through, most likely a meteoroid, which appears to have disabled the vessel. Although the technology of the ship is severely outdated, it does possess some interesting engineering design choices, which we of course will try to adapt. Yeah, that's nothing we can do. Construction. Okay, I will try to read the events. Most of them, probably not all of them, because I already know many, and well, there's more interesting stuff I think to do, but I will for sure read the if we find any ancient digging sites expeditions, I will read those for sure, and maybe some of the other events that are a little bit more interesting. Picking up life signs. Okay, let's investigate, because that wasn't that hard. Should we slow down a little? We're already 3 years in. Normally, I would like to have a colony by now, if we can. We only need the alloys to do so. I would like. Yeah, challenging. Don't care. We have to decide many things in the coming years. Just what will we do when we meet aliens? Apparently there are some, because we were destroyed by non-humans. That's all we know. So everyone could be substance abuser. Great. Everyone could be dangerous, potentially. Everyone could kill us. Everyone could be out to murder us by putting up a facade of friendliness and then stabbing us in the back. And we can't let that happen. So we may want to go into policies and change something there. Amazingly, while conducting their survey of 377D-35D, the crew of the TSS Noble picked up several life signs coming from within the asteroid. There appears to be a colony of large burrowing worm-like lithovores, so stone-eating worms, or worm-likes. Within the rock, which has been riddled with tunnels, these unique life forms have somehow adapted to a life in the coldness of space. These creatures should be studied. Yes, they should be. And we have enough for our colony ship, and we want this. This planet offers low habitability. Yeah, that's a problem, but we can't afford to not do this. Ceradon Prime, that's fine. Actually, would have liked a nameless from Battletech. That would have been cool for planets, and then put that into the game. But nope, I didn't do that. I wrote the backstory, so I mean, come on, yeah. How much should I do before I just start playing? I'm still sad about what I did. Yeah, we should before we encounter aliens. We don't even know that there's life out there. We know from some worm-like creatures, but yeah, we don't know about life. Sentient life. Yeah, our first contact protocol. We could set it to aggressive or to cautious, in my opinion. We could also put up a facade of being friendly, of being proactive. I think we were destroyed. There was a big threat that suddenly was gone. We don't know why. Probably after several days, months, weeks of bombing. Glassing the planet, which made it harder to investigate the structure still left for us. And without infrastructure, everything takes more time, of course. So having an aggressive approach would make sense, but we don't want to make the same mistakes than before, and having bad diplomacy with everyone, and then wonder why we get stabbed in the back and destroyed, which is kinda what happened to the Star League, not from aliens, but from internal affairs. Still, we don't want to just put up an aggressive wall and isolate ourselves completely. We have to find information. We have to gather information and find out what happened, why everything was destroyed. Maybe the whole galaxy was destroyed. So if we find a race that is not the big enemy, then we have to find out what they know. We have to get in contact with them. Although we shouldn't be naive, we should do that with a bit of caution. So we won't attack outright, but establishing communications will be a cautious and monitored process that has to follow certain rules for us not to expose important information. Touches on something I don't really like about this process, because everyone always knows where your home system is, your capital, which doesn't make sense. You wouldn't disclose your capital. You would disclose maybe the closest outpost of your empire and your maybe the corner they shouldn't pass, but never your capital. That's a different matter. Still, we don't want to give away important information that could be turned against us, so we will be cautious. They are less likely, there's less of a chance for negative events that could happen to us. Well, okay. And the target difficulty is a little bit higher, but that's fine. We want this. This is okay. Diplomatic stance, yeah, we want to be, we are expansionists. We don't hide that fact. We will expand and they will have to live with that. Easy as that. War philosophy, we don't care. If anyone threatens us, we will murder them. That is what our Empress said, and we will hold that to the letter. Orbital bombardment. There were years where we didn't even have ships, and that hurt us, because we weren't ready to bombard our enemies. Because we were afraid that our planets would die and we couldn't live on them anymore. The galaxy is big, though, and we are few, so we don't care at this moment what happens when we are at war with someone. They need to be brought into the fold. They need to brought to their knees to surrender, and we will do this with every means necessary. Resettlement, that's fine. Just moving our population from one planet to another for their own benefit is absolutely something that we are concerned about and that we are allowed to do. The first contact protocol we already tapped on. Initial border status, I would say it should be closed. We will not be able to change our stance. Yeah, the borders of our empire must be well guarded lest we fall victim to insidious influences, which is exactly the theme. Only those who have proven themselves worthy may enter our space. Exactly. I want that. I as the Empress. As the beautiful Empress. Sorry about that. It just came over me. Economic policy. A militarized economy. Yeah, we want to be prepared, and our populace may suffer from that, but it needs to be done. We need to be prepared this time, and we will build ships and we will use everything in our power to survive this time. Trade policy, wealth creation, that should be fine. We could help our populace with some consumer benefits, but I don't think that's necessary. We have to keep everything running, and we need energy for that. Robotic workers, we aren't opposed to robots, if they help us. It is a new thought. Normally we used power armor-like stuff or worker mechs, but we unfortunately have given up on mechs, on mech warriors and battle mechs. Sad thing, but I couldn't have the mod running with achievements enabled, and I still want achievements. So we tend to use robots instead of manned war machines and and focus more on defending space directly, not defending the planet that much. We can use normal warfare for that. Population controls, yeah, that's fine. Slavery, so far, we don't care. We will see how that pans out in the future. Purging, yeah, purging is fine. We may want to keep others out of our space. And if this space is recently conquered, that is fine. We will deport them to their empire if necessary, or to anyone who will take them, probably. Which is not concerning in any way whatsoever, of course. We will see. Strategic resource discovered. Okay, we have the Zro. This is an interesting resource, which is why I want to read that. During its survey of Jolderun 5A, the TSS Hubble discovered a previously unknown strategic resource dubbed Zro. It is an extremely rare aerosol of exotic particles that appears to have been deposited here through a meteor impact, but its true origin is a mystery. If ingested by psionically gifted individuals, this aerosol should act as a very potent and potentially addictive drug that enhances psi abilities. While we do not yet possess the means to extract this resource, we should seriously consider establishing control over the system for future exploitation. Yeah, I don't think we can even take that, because we are not religious in any way whatsoever. We are materialists. We care for the worldly, not for the otherworldly. So, who cares about Zro? Actually, I do know what Zro is made of, and if they would know, they wouldn't snort it, I guess. Well, they would. I mean, there are always weird people out there, I know. Okay. It's a good start. So far, our science ship is left doing nothing. That is not a good sign. Take these two. And then go probably here. Okay, we want to know what's around us ASAP, because we have to make hard decisions. Where to go, where to expand, what to expect out there. This looks pretty good. These are good numbers. And this is really good. 24 continental? Oh my god. The 13 is not that great, but since our second planet, these two were guaranteed. Since the second planet isn't really good. Although we could still take that, we will see. The 24 is amazing, so we want that system as soon as we are able to get it. Anything we could take in the meantime? Yes, this one for some more energy credits, which is okay. But is this worth it yet? Maybe this one then. Because we need, of course, influence to expand. Scientist leveled up, that's fine. Anything on Terra we should do? I still think we should do it. We should... although that will cut in our alloy production. We should make a holotheater just to get more unity and to further advance our society. Starbase influence cost, new colony stuff, additional pop. This is potent. As soon as we can get this, it's amazing. Extra pop is amazing too. Alien writing. Someone used a mining laser from orbit approximately 5,000 years ago to carve a large body of writing into the surface of Jolderun 5A. The massive script covers a large portion of the moon's upper hemisphere and appears to be a short story chronicling the difficult life of an alien mercenary. How nice. Anomaly found. So we know there are apparently either a very old scriptures from drunk people out there, or maybe aliens. I mean, that's just a short story. Anyone could have written that. That's not conclusive evidence for the existence of aliens. But you never know, right?
Tactical.
Oh, that's interesting. Let's see who they are. And we can't, because I left the game running. I'm an idiot. Okay, probably not an empire. It's not an empire. We have made first contact with mysterious aliens in the Tau City system, so now it is confirmed. For now, we have codenamed them Gamma Aliens until we can find out more about them. If they possess a language, we should decipher it, so that we can assess how much of a threat they pose. Which makes sense, so we should get our envoy, Daisy Jacobs, to investigate. And maybe seek contact. Cautiously, of course. Because we don't want to open doors for anyone to hurt and harm us.
Colonization in progress.
That should not happen. And we're colonizing our first planet. That is great. Okay, you have nothing to do anymore. Oh my god, this is these lanes. They are strange. We will be boxed in somewhat since there's apparently no lane going out from here. But that may be fake. There may are lanes that go out to all sides. Yeah, I want this. I want this system. We need it. ASAP. We really need that. We want the planet. And we want to colonize this planet yesterday, if at all possible. And even more. Now I want to see what these are. Oh. Oh, that's bad. This thing is bad, the crystalline station. Looks amazing, but damn, that's bad. Okay. That'll take a while. So these systems are impossible to traverse for us. Interesting. We have new research. I think since there are so many enemies already around, or hostile aliens of some kind or another, these are probably crystals too. Probably. I think we have to protect ourselves. And the best defense, of course, is offense. So we will take the offensive option instead of the defensive one. Okay, we have workers that are unemployed. That should change in a second. That's better. That's way better. Okay, so we have one of the duelist jobs fulfilled. Yeah, luckily you cannot set the colony designation here. Because that is dumb. It's not a rural world. That's my capital, man. Oh, and you are... Well, you're cheap, so that's fine. If you die before your time, I don't really care. There's a lot of new stuff we have to investigate. So, our research division on our planet, on our still very much harmed planet... is a little bit stressed. So, we may want more research labs. And I think we will have them. I think we do. And to accompany those, we need more minerals. Oh, more minerals. Bad. We should get rid of some wastelands that are left over from the war. Exotic gases. Yes, do the routine stuff. We need to get rid of some wastelands, of some slums. We need to refurbish our planet. Living crystals? The irregular... Irregularity, I can't speak sometimes. We had designated as gamma aliens. Appears to be made of some sort of crystalline material. Curiously, it seems to be... able to propel itself across the void and protect itself when necessary, indicating that it may be alive. Our researchers are working hard to find out more. And yeah, that is something completely new to us. I mean, living crystals. Who would have ever thought about that? We apparently didn't, so... It's fine, it's fine. We will deal and adapt to the deal with the situation and adapt to the new situation. We will prevail this time. So we can't research these systems. So we will probably redirect you to go to the north in here and look at these systems. We may want to automate our exploration soon. I hope we can get the tech, but I'm not very versed in how to trigger tech to spawn for us. So, we will ignore that. And we're already... Could you please stop? Thank you. We are already... okay. We are already 30 minutes in, so after this event, I will stop the first part, I will put a cut in here, and we will see each other next time. The TSS, and TSS stands for Terran Star, Terran Starship, Goddard crew has, the TSS Goddard crew has succeeded in isolating a signal embedded within the unusual pattern of interference in the Elbiri system. Elbiri system, okay. The signal is a song, a complex sonification of an advanced mathematical equation, to be precise, and one that science officer Marina Volkova cannot seem to get out of their head. Who or what may have composed this song remains unknown, though its complexity infers that an incredible level of technological sophistication regarding subspace harmonics. The signal's geodesics suggest a point of origin from outside of our galaxy, so apparently our galaxy is not all there is. Interesting. So there are, well, we know there are other galaxies, but we know stuff happens in them that exceeds the normal, just the normal life cycle of a star and the planets surrounding it and stuff. So interesting, very interesting. But this shall be it for the first part. I hope you enjoyed. We will see each other next time, probably the next day or the next week or something. We will see. We will see how many episodes will air from this. And I hope you enjoy. Please tell me if you enjoy. Please leave me a like. Sub to my channel if you're not subbed. It really helps. And yeah, tell me everything you like about Stellaris, and do you like the new patch that's coming? I am excited, kind of worried about some things that change, but we can discuss that in chat, and I see you next time. Goodbye.